Hey guys, Andrew, welcome back to the channel. So guys, buckle in, this one's going to be a wild ride. So guys, if you're new here, welcome. I'm Andrew. I talk about life with a disability and navigating the NDIS from a client's side. So guys, bear that in mind as we jump into this today. So guys, I've noticed a lot of support workers on social media. That is great. It's amazing. It's getting the word out of what you guys do. But sometimes the message or portrayal of the job can be exceedingly misleading. I recently discussed this with several people, including my own care team, friends on social media who is a gem of a support worker, and I only know this person through social media. One support worker, and it wasn't the same support worker, it's just another content creator, mentioned a story time that just, guys, really rubbed me the wrong way. She seemed to feel entitled, and there's been several posts telling other support workers how to do their jobs, which made me realize just how political this field is. From the support workers, support coordinators, the LACs, like, guys, but a support worker politics felt to me like the mean girls in high school all over again. So it just rubbed me the wrong way. First of all, the client she talked about was an ex-client she worked with as a child. Okay, what about client confidentiality there? And the client's now an adult. I have a question. If the client's now an adult, did the client want to see the support worker? Is the support worker allowed to see the client? Because sometimes there is clauses that you can't see that person for a certain amount of time because of the power dynamic in the relationship. So if you want to become friends as an adult, they recommend 3 months. I don't know what it is for children that are aging out of early intervention. So the first of all, the way that the support worker talked about the ex-client, so the support involved the client as an adult, with the support worker walking behind them, engrossed in their phone, and the client pointed to a swing. The client walked to it and got on it. The client looked disappointed. Okay, fair enough. The support worker then felt entitled to have a conversation with the current support worker on the spot about being in their phone. The exact words are, she called them out on it. Okay, I understand the frustration with support workers constantly being on their phones. We shouldn't assume that they're ignoring the client. Guys, Deb and I have said this time and time and time and time and time and time and time again, that what you guys see out in public is 1% of what a support worker does in a day. You shouldn't assume that they're ignoring the client. They could be asking permission to do something, writing notes, looking up information, filing an incident report, asking permission to do something. Calling out the support worker could put both the support worker and the client at serious risk. It's not your place to judge the other support worker's behaviour. Doing so, guys, can actually cause serious harm. Just stop, think, and don't. And guys, grow up. If you're seeing someone having a meltdown in public and they're wearing a sunflower lanyard, keep the person safe. Yes. But if you're seeing them with a sunflower lanyard and a support worker, and it's clearly the support worker on shift, okay, things that you can do to help, if there's shopping, if there's groceries, if there's baggage, if there's another client, stand a safe distance away. Watch those things. Guys, by getting involved, DRABC, danger, be aware of the danger to yourself. Guys, it's frustrating to see people policing other behaviours on platforms like TikTok. Guys, personally, I have actually had people message me about the language I'm using. And then when I talked to my own care team about the words I was using, they looked at me as I had two heads. And so, guys, offence is not harm. If you're offended, it means you're paying attention. But why are you being offended on other people's behalf? That's not your job. Thanks, Sing! So, guys, it just gives me a bad vibe when support workers are posting this online. And, guys, this particular content creator, she often posts about how support workers should be behaving, what they should be doing, taking their clients out in the sun. There are actually conditions where it's harmful for the client to be out in the sun, guys. And, guys, she seems to have worked in pre-NDIS, what we call block funding days. So block funding is where you didn't get funding that you could use how you use it. You got blocks of support time, and basically that was, the theory was, you get what you get and you don't get upset. Guys, that actually led to more abuse, neglect. It was more common due to the lack of choice and control in particularly group homes as well. So group homes have now been abolished. They're SIL homes, and there is much more open door policy as well. And guys, there's a foundation of the NDIS, choice and control. And I've seen a lot of support workers think it's their choice, their control, but it's actually about the client. And the quicker that agencies realise that, the better it's going to be for everyone. Guys, then to calm myself down, went to Reddit. Rookie error, Andrew. So I saw then a post about that I'm going to actually do another video on, about useless support worker, which backs up the negative attitudes that some support workers have towards disabilities, especially psychosocial disabilities. So things like your ADHD, anxiety, the mental effects of epilepsy. So psychosocial disabilities are those that affect your thinking and your engagement with the world, but you don't necessarily have a physical disability. And the post mentioned that support workers not reading this adolescence care plan and then complaining that it's such a difficult client. Guys, that's just poor planning. Guys, there are some basic things to be a support worker. It's read the care plan, do your homework, doing your notes, reading the progress note, know the plan goals, know the SIL house rules, and if you're turning up at the start time, like that's when you're driving in that client's driveway. No. Guys, you're in the wrong industry if that's... Because, guys, working with complex clients, yeah, it requires preparation and understanding. But you know what that cavalier attitude does? Guys, it can cause harm. And when you're causing harm, that can cause death. Guys, I hate to end this one on such a negative note, but support workers, you should be all playing on that same team. Whether you're independent, whether you're agency, inter-agency collaboration. Guys, stop. Guys, if you keep behaving like this, you're going to end up on Reddit's Am I the Asshole page. Yeah, you're going to be voted the asshole because this is asshole behaviour. The sun does not shine out of your ass, neither does it shine out of mine. You're not here to bless people or to help people. You're here to work with those people. While it's lovely to be blessing and caring and praying for people, guys, respect the choice and control. So, guys, if you can do me a favour by liking, sharing, subscribing, I'll see you guys in the next video.